My sauce. I make it myself.
Huh. You carry your own sauce?
Doesn't everybody?
Like, it's kind of good. You sure you made this by yourself?
What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Zoe, and you tuned into another episode of The Secret Sauce. And today I'm going to be talking to you about being yourself. This world is full of a lot of followers nowadays. Everybody want to be a follower, and I blame it half on social networks because they says right there, follower. Instagram, Twitter, nothing against the social networks because I use them, but they do program your mind to be a follower instead of a leader. There's too many followers in this world and not enough leaders. Everybody want to be like somebody else. Everybody want to dress like somebody else. Everybody want to talk like somebody else, think like somebody else. A lot of people can't even think for themselves anymore. But I encourage you to be a leader. Don't be a follower because there's too many of them. We're full. That room is full. Let's be a leader because that bus is empty. Enter into a new field. Lead the way and not care about what other people think. Too many people is around here caring about the opinion of other people instead of doing what they got to do to get on their grind. I assure you that if you pay attention and block out everybody else, all your distractions, all your side influences, all your friends, or everybody, anybody, if you was to block all that out, I guarantee you you'll be more successful because you'll be focused. That's a whole nother topic right there, focus. Laser point focus, where you have a goal in mind and you refuse to let anything keep you from achieving that goal. But too many people trying to be like other people. Be yourself. I'm sure that when you walk into a room, you walk in there and then you are looking to be accepted. You're looking to get a certain type of treatment. You walk into the room and you wonder if they like you. But how about you walk into that room and you ask yourself if you even like them? You're forcing yourself to try to get along with people that you don't even know or that you don't even really like on the inside just to feel accepted. That's horrible. That's whack to me. Don't do that. You can't be that type of person where you just want to be accepted by everybody, or you want to be a people pleaser, or you care about what people think, or your level of grind is based off of somebody else's opinion, or your determination factor or your determination level is based off what somebody else thinks about you. You should go into a meeting, you should go into school, you should go into class, you should go into work with the mindset that you are you and you're going to do you regardless of what anybody else think or got to say about it, because at the end of the day, it's about you. You got to do what you got to do for you to be successful. Be yourself. If people can't love you for you, then they don't really love you at all. Realize who your true friends are. Realize who's really for you, who got your back, and who don't. If they don't accept you for who you are, so be it. Still be yourself. Don't change up for nobody. So when you walk into a room and you ask yourself if you even like them, your circle begins to change. When your circle gets smaller, your vision gets clearer. You're able to see more clearer, you're able to use more wisdom, and you're able to make better decisions. Warren Buffett, he reads about 6 books a day. 6 books a day. That is the habit of a billionaire versus the habit of the average working man. The average American reads about 1 book a month, if that. Warren Buffett reads about 6 books a day, and he's a billionaire, and got half of his wealth after the age of 40. So obviously, knowledge is power. I heard that saying too many times, but it is true. Knowledge is power. With it, you can do anything. By him reading 6 books a day, he's able to make better decisions with his investments. He's able to pay attention to the stock market. He's able to focus on the stock market fluctuation, the rise and fall of different percentages at different points. He's able to pay attention to trends because of his knowledge from books. Reading 6 books a day, it's really hard to make a bad decision. You have too much knowledge and understanding, and you're able to make a very, very good decision based off a couple books you read. So I encourage you to read books. Be yourself. Be yourself. Focus on you. Don't pay attention to the next man. Don't pay attention to the next woman. Get it how you live. You gotta grind, live it out. Do what you gotta do. Don't worry about the acceptance of other people. Accept yourself. Get on your grind, and when you hustle, it's contagious. Other people want to hustle, and other people end up following you. That's all I'm going to say, man. Be yourself. You're watching The Secret Sauce. So.